model to test his fidelity.
Yeah, drinks. Everything's fine with me.
Busted. The new series, Anything for Love, premieres Monday, June 16th on Fox.
We move into the sixth inning here at Wrigley Field, and Roger Clemens is at the plate. Clemens dropped down a very good sacrifice bunt his first time. Now he's up there trying to catch up to Kerry Wood, who has struck out eight. Sixth inning, 1-0 Yankees on the home run by Matsui. Clemens and Soriano, then Jeter. 0-2. With everything that's going on the field, we barely scratched the surface with the Sosa situation.
Yeah.
Hardly talked about Joe Torre and the ups and downs he's gone through personally and professionally with this Yankee situation, as 9 strikeouts now are on the board for Kerry Wood. With one out, nobody on, Alfonso Soriano walks in. The only reason I brought up earlier about the barrel of the bat having Sosa's name on it, I think it would work in a way to Sosa's defense if his name was on the barrel of the bat that was corked that broke in the game. If it isn't, if it's a blank bat or if it's the name, you go through these bat racks in a dugout and you can find names on bats from guys who have been traded 10 years ago.
That's true. That's right.
I mean, there may be a McCarver bat down in the bat rack right now for the Cubs.
I was traded a little longer than 10 years ago.
You never know. But these bats have a way of lingering.
Yeah, that's true.
And if a guy grabs onto a bat that he likes and it doesn't break and a guy moves on, the bat sometimes stays behind. Or guys retire. One ball, one strike on Soriano. But if his name isn't on the barrel of the bat, and again, the barrel of the bat hasn't been found, then them checking 76 of Sosa's bats with his name on them doesn't mean anything. I think it'd just be interesting to see if they found the barrel of the bat, which is missing. Bat boy grabs it after the barrel of the bat breaks on that Tuesday night against Tampa Bay, and it hasn't popped up since. It will. I guarantee it will. But not now. One ball, two strikes. Two balls, two strikes.
It is just a... the talk of this town, the talk of the, as you brought up in the opening, it's overwhelmed all the other sports stories in baseball and other sports.
On 2-2. That's a foul ball. And we've all heard by now, or most have heard, the charges by Pedro Martinez and others that it's racially motivated. And believe me, I have no business stepping out on this limb because I'm not a Latin ball player in the big leagues, but my personal opinion is that there is so much awe involved here because Sammy Sosa is so loved,
right?
Because he is such a hero to so many in the game, that it was stunning and heartbreaking in a way that there was cork in his bat.
Yeah, there's empathy for Sosa, not the reverse.
How can you not love Sammy Sosa with the way he plays this game? The home runs that he hits, 3 times he has hit 60 or more home runs, the only player in Major League Baseball history to do it. That moment here at Wrigley, carrying the American flag around with him on a home run tour, and then playing to the cameras the night in September of 98 with McGuire, looking at the fans smiling. I mean, this guy is everything to me that's right with the game of baseball, and then that happens and it's like throwing a stick in the spokes of some kid riding a bike.
People are dumbfounded. Baseball fans are saying, how can that happen?
With 2 out, nobody on, an 0-1 pitch to Jeter is high and tight, a ball and a strike.
Joe, earlier in the game we saw Sosa between innings saying hello to Hideki Matsui. Matsui was with the Yomiuri Giants when Sosa was over there, an unbelievably popular figure in Japan. So you have to wonder what the Japanese people are thinking right now of their hero, Sammy Sosa, who used a cork bat, has apologized for it. Matsui, of course, the reason I bring that up right now, he's the difference in this ball game.
Two out, nobody on, a ball and two strikes on Jeter. Just blown away. And strikeout number 10 Another double-digit strikeout day for Kerry Wood. But the only number that matters to him and the Cubs, one. They're down 1-0, bottom of the sixth.
No matter where you are, with Sprint wireless phones from Radio Shack, you can take and send pictures instantly. Not that I'm going Hollywood or anything. So come to Radio Shack, your wireless phone headquarters.
Isn't that...
Get PCS Vision Picture Phone with Picture Mail that talks from Sprint. Take and send pictures with a recorded message just $99.99.
I knew it was him.
It was him.
Not that I'm going Hollywood or anything.
Radio Shack.
The best things in life are pure. Aquafina, purity guaranteed.
Now may be the best time ever to buy a Carrier heating and cooling system. Introducing Cool Cash, where you can get a rebate of up to $600 on qualifying new Carrier systems. Call 1-800-CARRIER for a participating dealer.
The Bronze Synchro gives you bronze closest shave ever. And its automatic self-cleaning system leaves your shaver so clean, it feels like new every day. Braun, designed to make a difference.
Designing an all-season tire to outperform performance tires wasn't rocket science. Then again, maybe it was. Pilot Sport AS, our most advanced C-rated tire ever. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Commissioner of Baseball and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without express written consent.
We move to the bottom of the sixth inning. The Cubs bat. They have the bottom two in their lineup. Miller, then Kerry Wood, then Grescelonic. 1-0 Yankees on the Hideki Matsui home run, which happened in the fifth with two out. And a riding fastball from Clemens is high for ball one. Miller, his first time, grounded out to short. It was a 5-3 victory here yesterday for the Yankees over Chicago, and that's pretty well hit down the left field line. Off the bat of Damian Miller into the corner, and it's a fair ball. Miller will cruise into second with a leadoff double. While Kerry Wood walks to the plate, the person he collided with, Hee-Sop Choi, is at the hospital for a brief update. Let's go down to Kevin Kennedy.
Thanks, Joe. I talked to the PR department of the Cubs. They said Dr. Steven Adams went with Hee-Sop Choi to the hospital. It's less than a half a mile away. He was conscious and moving when he got into the ambulance. So that's good news, I think.
Good news. And if we know any more, we'll pass it on. And they plan to announce something to the crowd if they have something more concrete before the end of this game. Right now, Wood is trying to get Miller over to third.
Keep in mind, Giambi has a poor throwing arm at first base. If you bunted hard to him, throwing to third would be a remote possibility. The one flaw in Giambi's game is he is a very, very poor thrower.
The former third baseman is Giambi. It's back to Clemens. He has no problem throwing. And out at third is Miller, one away.
That's why you try to bunt the ball toward the weaker part of the infield. If you bunt it to Giambi, he doesn't make that play. But Clemens, even at the age of 40, very adept at coming off the mound. The ball bunted hard. Damian Miller is not a fast runner. He's a catcher. And a fairly easy play. Watch Ventura. He moves in and now back. The turn and the throw by Clemens in time to get the slow-footed Miller.
Did you happen to catch Clemens' reaction? Like a 20-year-old rookie.
Yeah, that's a big, big play in this ball game.
Now they're looking at the glove hand of Ventura. Ventura got spiked by Damian Miller as he came sliding into third base.
A lot of times when a third baseman's trying to catch the ball, he knows the runner's near, and when he comes back, he doesn't know where the spikes are. That was a clean play by Miller, just a straight in slide. But Ventura's backs to the play. He doesn't really know, but he comes over. He doesn't know where the spikes are, and it ends up going above the glove. Nice play by Ventura, but he suffered an injury in the process. Wood's upset because he bunted the ball back to Clemens, and he should be.
So Wood now has to run the bases, one on, one out. And Clemens gets a chance to loosen that throwing arm as now everything appears to be okay, or at least okay enough for Ventura to continue. So a leadoff double, and the Cubs and Kerry Wood can't take advantage of it. The bunt back to Clemens. The fielder's choice, 1-5. And now it's a runner at first, one out. For Gresolani, who's hit the ball well today. He has singled. He has lined to center. Too far inside and no swing, says the first base umpire.
It's a weird play for Kerry Wood. A strikeout would have been better than what happened for the Cubs. Not only that, was the runner erased at third base, but now Wood has to run the bases.
Home plate umpire Dan Iasonia, who on what could be a very historic day is working the plate. Dan Iasonia is listed as a triple A reserve umpire. And he's working the plate here at Wrigley Field with Roger Clemens and Kerry Wood hooking up, as Kerry Wood is on the short end of a 1-0 Yankee lead as Clemens pours one in for strike two. Clemens with 299 career victories and four strikeouts on the afternoon. To the right side, not hard hit. Soriano and Jeter, they only get the lead man, and Kerry Wood went in, spikes high on Derek Jeter.
Doing his job is one way to put it. Angry at not getting the runner to third is another way to put it. Because arguably, that little weak ground ball by Gresolani, had Damian Miller been on third, is a run, and this game's tied, and Wood knows it. Yankees making sure of one, and they got it.
And the Yankees breathing a sigh of relief that Derek Jeter was able to get out of the way of that big body of Kerry Wood barreling down on him. So it's a runner at first, two out, and Alex Gonzalez, who has dropped down a bunt and grounded out, stands in.
Alex coming over from the Toronto Blue Jays last year, and he has got a ton of big hits for the Chicago Cubs. 8 game-winning hits and last at bats. Mr. Walk-off, they refer to him.
No balls and a strike. Our Sprint virtual manager question: which cap should be on the head of Clemens on his plaque in Cooperstown? And 55% said Yankees as opposed to Red Sox. With Boston, he won 192 games from 1984 to 1996. In Toronto, he was there 2 years. Clemens was there in 97 and 98. He had 41 wins and 2 Cy Young awards, and then traded to the Yankees in February of 99 for David Wells, Graham Lloyd, and Homer Bush. Wells is his teammate with the Yankees. Graham Lloyd pitches for the Mets, and Homer Bush isn't playing anymore. Runner at first, two out. No balls and a strike on Gonzalez. Gresolani running, and the throw by Posada sails into center field. And now Gresolani will be 90 feet away with two out.
the second stolen base of the year for Greg Zelenik. He chose a good pitch on which to run. It was a splitter that was effective. Looked like a slider, not a splitter. But a poor throw by Posada gets by Soriano. That in-between hop over the glove of Soriano and a throwing error on Posada. Now that kind of changes the way you call the game if you're Posada. You've already committed an error. If you call for the splitter, which could be the right pitch, that could be the pitch that rolls to the backstop. Remember earlier, we said last year, Posada with a problem catching the ball.
Too far outside, one ball, two strikes.
Clemens thought that was a strike.
Yeah, I think he let go a little yelp at the end of not getting that called for strike three. Runner at third, two out. It's the tying run. And Gonzalez hits it hard, and what a play by Ventura. Robin Ventura, who starred on the south side, dashes the hopes of the fans on the north side with that play. Still 1-0. Back after this from your local Fox station.
With home field advantage in the World Series at stake, this time it counts. The 2003 All-Star Game on Fox.
You want the best values in America? Well, they're here now at the Dodge Summer Sales Drive,
where you'll find our best products.
Like the Hemi-powered Ram Heavy Duty, Motor Trend's 2003 Truck of the Year.
And Caravan, the best-selling minivan, now with our best deals, up to $4,500 cash allowance or 0% financing for up to 60 months.
All with Dodge's 7-year, 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty.
Let us prove we got the best values in America. Hurry to your Dodge dealer today.
Okay, let's say this is your car and you get into an accident. Oh boy. If you take it to an Allstate recommended repair shop, they'll fix it, so you're pretty happy. You're like, woohoo, I'm pretty happy. Even better, Allstate guarantees the workmanship for as long as you own the car, which means if even the smallest thing goes wrong, you don't have to pay for it. So you're still happy. You're like, woohoo, I'm still happy. So there you go, the Allstate Lifetime Repair Guarantee. Call now and find out how you're in good hands with Allstate.
It's kind of like that. Sierra Mist. Taste one shockingly refreshing lemon lime.
Good dog.
You want the best values in America?
They're here now. At the Chrysler Summer Sales Drive, you'll find exciting new products.
Like America's favorite convertible, Sebring.
The versatile PT Cruiser.
And great deals like cash allowances up to $3,500 or 0% financing for 60 months on select models.
Plus, Chrysler's 7-year, 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty.
Let us prove we've got the best values in America. Hurry into your Chrysler dealer today.
On the final word, Sunday night, we're live at Wrigley with the Cubs and Yankees.
This game moves into the seventh inning. It's a 1-0 game, a total of 3 hits. And Giambi gets out of the way of ball one inside. It'll be Giambi, Posada, and Ventura. Robin Ventura has made a couple of very good plays to help Clemens keep the Cubs off the board in this game. Two balls, no strikes from Kerry Wood. ~94 inside for ball three.
Robin Ventura with a run-saving play to end the sixth inning.
On 3-0, Giambi takes a 4-pitch walk. Number one in the American League now with 42 walks is Giambi, and that's the second handed out by Kerry Wood today.
Joe, normally in the seventh inning, when you look down at your scorecard and you see a team has only gotten 3 balls out of the infield all day, you don't expect to be ahead. But one of those balls, a home run by Hideki Matsui for the Yankees. Three balls have been hit out of the infield today.
One by Soriano, the home run, and the flyout to shallow right by Juan Rivera. That's it. A strike hits the inside corner to Jorge Posada. We expected a good pitching matchup, and we are getting every bit of it. The combined efforts of the two Texans, Roger Clemens and Kerry Wood, here this afternoon. The opposite way, Moises Alou back to get it. One on, one out. So Giambi's aboard. Robin Ventura's coming up. And I want to wish a happy seventh birthday to my beautiful daughter, Natalie.
All right.
Number seven on the seven.
All right.
Little Nat.
That's great.
We're in the top of the seventh. A runner at first, one out. A run on the board. That's it. It belongs to the Yankees. And Robin Ventura has struck out twice. As we just said, his contribution to this game has come with a glove on his left hand. One ball, no strikes. Even the play that he made at third, backing up to take the throw from Clemens, which was about 95 miles an hour, to get the tag down on Miller last half inning, was a big play.
Certainly not a routine play. He caught it foul territory, had to come back to make the tag.
One ball, one strike. You think your guy Bobby Mercer behind us is getting a little nervous?
Look at this. He's going to sing "Take Me Out to the Ball Game." He's wow. The show in about 5 minutes or 3 minutes, the way this game's going.
We'll save the public and go to commercial. One ball, one strike, one on, one out. And a ball down and in, 2-1. There's Bobby Mercer. There's the top of Tim's hair.
Well, I've heard Bobby sing the blues a lot. I've never heard him sing "Take Me Out to the Ball Game."
Nor do we particularly want to.
No.
Here's a 2-1 to Ventura. Off the hands. Good pitch by Kerry Wood. 2-2. To look at the big picture for a moment, the Yankees come in after having fallen out of first place this past week with two terrible games at Cincinnati to start this interleague action. Now they're a game and a half up on Boston in the AL East. Meanwhile, the Cubs, with last night's victory by Houston, come from behind over Tampa Bay. The Cubs are out of first place for the first time since the 15th of April, tied with St. Louis, both teams a game out behind Houston. And what a year for Joe Torre. Finding out from his general manager, Brian Cashman, that Derek Jeter had been named the 11th captain in team history for the Yankees while they were in Cincinnati. Of all places. He didn't get the call from George Steinbrenner. He finds out from Brian Cashman, and from the reports, when Jeter signed his contract a couple of years ago, Joe Torre was cool to the idea. People then take the action by Steinbrenner to be a little jab at Joe Torre's power and leadership of this Yankee team on the field by doing so and not consulting him. Two balls, two strikes. Full count now on Ventura.
Not only that, but when Derek Jeter signed the $19 million a year contract over 10 years, $190 million, the press conference was held over the weekend when press coverage is
on the telephone.
It was a conference call because George Steinbrenner was upset at Derek Jeter getting $19 million a year. Go figure. I mean, here's one of your stars, like General Motors making a good car and then saying it's not a real good car and trying to sell it, peddle it to the public. Give me a break.
Three balls, two strikes, runner at first, one out. Now what's Mercer doing back there?
Turning his back to us.
Here's a 3-2 pitch and a fly ball into left. Moises Alou takes it in, two out.
You know, we talked about that sequence and the 3-2 curveball to Matsui. The difference in this game, the batter before him, Raul Mondesi, swung and missed at a 3-2 breaking ball. That was the second out of the inning. And now the sequence to Matsui. Missed with the fastball. Now with the count 1-2. That's the disputed pitch. Did he go too far? Cubs thought so. The Yankees said no. And on the 3-2 curveball, difference in the ballgame. 1-0 New York.
Five breaking pitches in that series to Matsui. When nobody can hit his fastball today.
That's right. And the reason we showed that 3-2 breaking ball to Mondesi is a lot of young pitchers think that a good breaking ball to a right-handed batter would have a similar effect on a left-handed batter, and that is not true. And it's a very important point for young pitchers to know. Left-handers view them differently. They pick it up quicker.
Mondesi rips one into left field, but Alou ties a record. He made all three putouts in the inning. There you go. Bobby, it's all you. Time to stretch. 1-0 Yankees at Wrigley.
Do it, baby!
Just how close are you to finding a place with a spectacular view? Chances are, closer than you think. Bush. Head for the mountains of Bush.
Some people believe there's a carpentry gene, and I think I got it. Hanging things, I'm a little hit or miss on. But with the Black & Decker Bullseye, it's foolproof. I just find a stud, hang it on the wall, and it self-levels. Gives you a straight line every time.
The Bullseye from Black & Decker.
Now may be the best time ever to buy a Carrier heating and cooling system. Introducing Cool Cash, where you can get a rebate of up to $600 on qualifying new Carrier systems. Call 1-800-CARRIER.
GMC Yukon XL Denali.
I blow through here, and the music goes down and round.
The tightest turning radius in its class.
And comes on here. Press the first valve down, and the music
professional
goes
down grade engineering.
Round.
It's not more than you need, just more than you're used to.
And comes on here.
Fox Saturday Baseball brought to you by GMC. We are professional grade. We all had a nice seventh inning stretch. Bobby Mercer, an ex-Yankee and Cub, sang Take Me Out to the Ball Game, and a big rip by Corey Patterson, who's hit 12 home runs this season. We'd like to play you more of it, including his singing, but Simon Cowell of American Idol won't allow us to do that. The 0-1 pitch. It's bloody dreadful.
Bobby has a different...
loved it, though.
Bobby has a different accent.
One ball, one strike. Patterson, then Sosa, then Alou. Big bats in this inning for the Cubs to deal with Roger Clemens. Ooh, nasty.
Remember in the scouting report at the beginning of the game, we said arguably Roger Clemens throws the hardest spitter ever. Well, that was an example of one right there. 89 miles an hour. Split finger fastball that just dived out of the strike zone.
Another good rip. Well, you can see why they have high hopes for Corey Patterson. You heard about him a couple of years coming up through the minor leagues. Acevedo and Hammond in the bullpen. Man, if I'm Roger Clemens and I have a shot at 300 at Wrigley Field, I don't want to be sitting in the dugout watching Acevedo or Hammond try to help me get it.
Your point before the game that Rivera would be his choice.
Patterson strikes out. That's five strikeouts and 3,996 in the career of Roger Clemens.
Keep making pitches like that. You won't need anybody from the bullpen.
Bullpen let him down in Detroit. Will they get another opportunity here at Wrigley. Another battle between Clemens and Sosa. Sosa's 0 for 2. Hasn't homered in 36 days. Strike one. However, 95 starts since his last complete game. And the Yankee bullpen about 80% in guiding at home. I'm sure Clemens doesn't want to play the odds. He's had this hanging over him since the season began, as he makes his third attempt to win 300 in his career. One ball, one strike on Sosa. Rivera is another story, but the setup relief for the Yankees is not what it once was. Pretty good rip by Sosa. One ball, two strikes. Debbie Clemens, Roger's wife, watching. They have family. They have friends. I'm sure it's been an expensive couple of whiffs for Roger Clemens trying to win number 300 now that he has to bring the whole show to Wrigley Field and try to find seats for everybody. A 1-2.
It's so different for a team to wait for a pitcher to win 300 games as opposed to a team waiting for a hitter, for instance, like Sammy Sosa, to get 500 home runs, because he plays every day. If a guy like Roger Clemens doesn't do it, you're gonna have to wait five more days, more questions, all the luggage that comes with a remarkable feat.
A 1-2 to Sosa. Two balls, two strikes. Popped up. Still 2-2.
Move that pitch down about 4 inches and this game would be tied. He just missed that ball, but that's that rising action of the high Clemens fastball. Put that fastball down around the thighs instead of between the belt and the armpits, and this game could be tied. It sounds strange, but there is not much of a difference in a guy fouling a ball straight back and hitting the ball 400 feet.
It'll be interesting now to see how Clemens follows that pitch, if he goes back with the heat or after that high fastball goes to the split-fingered pitch to try to finish off Sosa.
I think the splitter would be my choice if I were Clemens.
Hideki Matsui out in center field. His home run, the only run of the day. 1-0 New York, bottom of the seventh.
Ball
on 2-2. .505 career home runs for Sosa.
Another fastball
and a ground ball through the left side for a one-out base hit. Tying run is on. Let's check in with Kevin Kennedy. Kevin.
Hey, there's one seat in the house, and it happens to be right behind Mrs. Clemens. This is Debbie. This is Corey, Roger's son. We got a bunch of family. Debbie, who's got more pressure on? Is it Roger or you? How are you handling this?
I'm trying to stay real calm and cool. Whenever it happens, it's going to happen. I just am really glad to enjoy a really good pitching duel right now. I think that Kerry and Roger are both pitching well. And let's just get the Yankees a win.
Now, if you don't think she knows how many strikeouts Roger has, what did you just tell me a moment ago, that last strikeout? Number what?
I said that was number 5.
How many more for 4,000?
I think he needs 4.
You got it. How many family and friends are here, Debbie?
Well, our party has kind of shrunk. There weren't that many tickets available for this sold-out series. But I brought my two older sons, and Roger's sisters are here. Okay. And we have a few friends, but it's a lot smaller party.
All right, Corey, how are you doing? You hanging in there pretty good?
Yes, I am. Go Yankees.
All right, we'll take it. Good luck, Debbie. Let's take it back upstairs.
All right, Kevin, thanks. Thanks to part of the Clemens family. And now with one on, one out, the batter is Moises Alou after a rather long visit from Mel Stottlemyre, the pitching coach. A base hit by Sosa, an 8-pitch at bat with Sosa. And now Alou takes the ball. Even with all the hype and all of the buildup, this is the second largest crowd of the season. 39,363, which begs the question, Joe, when was the largest crowd here at Wrigley? We'll find that out. Runner at first, the tying run. One away. Bottom of the seventh. 2-0.
Man, he is making some pitches that are tough to call. Your point earlier about Dan Iasone is nothing against Dan. I think Dan's going to be is a good umpire, but he's inexperienced, and you'd wonder why Major League Baseball would have a format to where a young, inexperienced umpiring staff is doing this series.
2-0, 3-0. Iasone is a Triple-A reserve umpire. That's what he's referred to as in the media guide, is Mel Stottlemyre and Joe Torre are discussing, I'm sure, how much longer they want to stay with Roger Clemens should Moises Alou reach.
Interesting situation. If Dusty Baker were hitting right now, he'd want to be hitting. We'll see if he gave Alou the hit sign.
On the corner.
I think he was hitting then, but that pitch right on the outside corner, and Alou properly took it. Watch the front side. That's not a taking mode. I think he was hitting, but it just caught the corner.
Alou surprised to hear strike one called. It's 3-1. Alou's hit 5 home runs this season. That is ball 4 as they appeal down to first. No swing, and it's 2-on with 1 out. And that's going to be it for Roger Clemens. A strikeout, a hit, a walk. And now the Yankees, as this crowd will let Joe Torre and the Yankees hear it. They're going to go to their bullpen here in the seventh inning and let Clemens sit and watch the rest of this. Ovation from this crowd now at Wrigley. Boy, unless Roger Clemens said something like, take me out if I don't get him, I would have a tough time justifying taking Clemens out of this game.
Yeah.
He's gone. Acevedo takes over.
You gelling?
No telling how much I'm gelling. You gelling?
You know I'm gelling.
Hey, Ellen, you gelling?
I'm gelling like a felon. You want some melon?
Nah, but hey, I'm like mud gelling. I'm so gelling.
Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles are made from the softest gel ever created. If you and your shoes don't feel outrageously comfortable, you get your money back, guaranteed.
I'm gelling.
You're not gelling.
You're so not gelling.
Are you gelling yet? Dr. Scholl's. Look, feel, do better.
You ready, my man?
I was born ready.
Hey, Rick, sure is getting close to lunchtime, huh?
It sure is, Jim.
Any ideas?
Well, Subway's got something delicious, like the new Chipotle Southwest Steak and Cheese. Sliced steak topped with melted cheese and a new Chipotle sauce for an added spicy kick. Served hot on fresh baked gourmet bread. You know, I can go for one right now.
Yeah. Whoa. Excellent work, my friend.
Yeah.
Subway, eat fresh!
Some people believe there's a carpentry gene, and I think I got it. Hanging things, I'm a little hit or miss on. But with the Black & Decker Bullseye, it's foolproof. I just find a stud, hang it on the wall, and it self-levels. Gives you a straight line every time.
The Bullseye from Black & Decker.
Now may be the best time ever to buy a Carrier heating and cooling system. Introducing Cool Cash, where you can get a rebate of up to $600 on qualifying new Carrier systems. Call 1-800-CARRIER for a participating dealer.
Okay, let's say this is your car and you get into an accident. Oh boy. If you take it to an Allstate recommended repair shop, they'll fix it, so you're pretty happy. You're like, woohoo, I'm pretty happy. Even better, Allstate guarantees the workmanship for as long as you own the car, which means if even the smallest thing goes wrong, you don't have to pay for it. So you're still happy. You're like, woohoo, I'm still happy. So there you go, the Allstate Lifetime Repair Guarantee. Call now and find out how you're in good hands with Allstate.
First pitch with two on and one out to Eric Karros, playing in place of the injured Hee-Sop Choi. Acevedo deals, and Karros hits it deep to left. This ball is gone. 3-1 Chicago, and Clemens will not get number 300 today.
Cubs put him on top.
That is a rocket hit to first, caught by Giambi. When Roger Clemens was taken out of the game, he let the home plate umpire Dan Iosonia, when he Clemens was in the dugout, have an earful. Only 84 pitches on the afternoon, still throwing 93 94 miles an hour. And again, as we said going to break, unless Roger Clemens said, I'm finished, get me out of here, if I don't get a Lou, I don't know how you can take him out of a game like this.
Well, you don't know whether he said that.
Oh, absolutely. That's the disclaimer.
Yeah, but especially with 84 pitches. Because if he's going to lose the game, you would think that Joe Torre would say, listen, he's going to lose the game, he's going to be the guy to do it, not the bullpen.
It was not Rivera coming in. It was Acevedo.
Right.
We're in the seventh inning. And this crowd is alive and well. A 3-1 Cub lead after 7 at Wrigley.
Come on in, Derek. I thought we discussed this thing and had it all worked out. You're our starting shortstop. How can you possibly afford to spend 2 nights dancing, 2 nights eating out, and 3 nights just carousing with your friends? Oh.
If you want to enjoy the New York nightlife, bring your Visa card. Because Orso, Cheetah, and the Broom Street Bar don't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Fleas and ticks on your lawn can be a real pain, right, Murphy? But even worse are the bugs that destroy your lawn from below. You see these dead brown patches? Cutworms and grubs eating the roots. The solution? Ortho Bug Be Gone. Bug Be Gone's exclusive formula kills the ants, fleas, and ticks above, and those lawn killers below. Ortho Bug Be Gone. for a beautiful bug-free lawn, guaranteed. Ortho, always the right solution.
I love a good thing. Who says too much of a good thing is a bad thing? Sometimes too much of a good thing can be a great thing.
Now you can call anyone in America for 3 cents a minute and 39 cents to connect. And that 3 cents gets you Canada and Western Europe too. Just dial 1010-987.
There's no monthly fees, so you only pay for the calls you make. Hey, you know a good thing when you see it.
1010-987. Rate this low never went so far.
What will happen when we check 11 sexy singles into the most beautiful hotel in the world? We can't wait to find out either. Paradise Hotel. You watch, you win, you could be in. Premieres Wednesday, June 18th on Fox. Parental discretion advised.
Eric Karras took over first base after a fourth inning injury to Hee-Sop Choi. Took the first pitch, a riding fastball coming in toward him. It was up, and Karras sent it up and out. And just like that, the Cubs went on top 3-1. Clemens, no chance in Chicago to win number 300. That will drag on because of this. And what a moment for Eric Karras, the longtime Dodger, to step to the plate and rip that ball out of the park.
Wasting no time against Juan Acevedo. Reinforce that point. I was surprised Clemens came out of the game after only 84 pitches. I think that's the key.
Well, now Matsui's on to start the inning here in the eighth for New York. Kevin Kennedy managed Roger Clemens with Boston. Kevin, your thoughts?
Joe, there's no way Roger asked out of that game. 84 pitches is nothing for him. As we were talking yesterday, he said, Skip, I remember so many times you'd come out to the mound, I'd have 125, and you'd say, hey, you're our best guy. He'd stay in there. As we've talked about all week, his legs are so strong, his mechanics are so good. There's no way he asked out of this ballgame. He never did in 2 years with me. If anything, he's forced himself to go back out for an extra inning when I wanted to take him out.
Runner at first with nobody out, Juan Rivera. It's called strike one. Ruben Sierra, the newest addition to this Yankee team, and you can be guaranteed that before the trading deadline rolls in this season, there will be additions to the setup relief corps for the New York Yankees. In fact, Joe Torre telling us before the game, he still believes Jose Contreras will be a major part of the bullpen for the Yankees before the end of the season.
And think about it, Jose Contreras has won his last two ball games as a starter.
Runner at first, nobody out, tying run at the plate. Rivera swings at a terrible pitch that bounced in there, a ball and two strikes.
That was a tightly wrapped 56-foot breaking ball thrown by Wood.
It happened last Sunday in Detroit, and it happened in a blink here in Chicago. And now it's Kerry Wood still on the mound, trying to get through the eighth. He is due to lead off in the bottom of this inning. That's called strike three over the outside corner, one out. 11 strikeouts today for Kerry Wood. Our Pepsi fan cam here in the eighth. A packed house at Wrigley. A lot of the kids in attendance here today, and to answer the question, the largest crowd at Wrigley Field this season, Memorial Day against Pittsburgh. They got over 40,000, just under it here today, but standing room only. And now with Rothschild pat on the backside, back to the dugout. It's one on, one out. And Ruben Sierra, recently picked up from the Texas Rangers, will step to the plate.
I remember back in the 1993 All-Star game, Tom Kelly, who was 1992 All-Star game in San Diego, Tom Kelly told me about Ruben Sierra. The one thing you can't do is speed up his bat head by throwing 85 mile an hour sliders. Well, if that was true in 92, it's particularly true right now. So I'm sure Larry Rothschild went out and said, if you float a breaking ball into this guy, he can hurt you. If he's going to hurt you, make him hurt you with the fastball.
Well, Sierra just took one for strike one, and it's one on, one out. that's a ball and a strike.
Sometimes you show him early in the count something other than what you're going to get him out with late in the count.
Tying run at the plate, Ruben Sierra. That big swing, which is a reason why you don't want to speed up his bat with something other than at least exactly what Wood possesses, a blow you away fastball that counts 1-2.
Some hitters, because of that big swing, take a long time to get to the strike zone. Ruben Sierra is one of those types of hitters.
279 career home runs. Back with the Yankees, takes ball two. 2-2. Three home runs this season with Texas. Sitting 263, nine doubles. Batting for Acevedo, who went two-thirds of an inning. One run on one big hit. That's a base hit through the right side. Matsui will hold at second. It's two on with one out. So Sierra comes through for Joe Torre off the bench. And it's our GMC game summary brought to you by GMC Professional Grade. In the top of the eighth inning, now the Yankees have a golden opportunity with two on and one out in the top of the order coming up. The numbers for Clemens, who right now is on the hook for the loss if the Yankees don't rally. Now we're going to have a pinch runner. The numbers for Wood, who's trying to get through eight. Matchup of two Texans, one 25 years old, one 40 years old. And the 25-year-old is still in the game. Gibson will take over at first base. As a pinch runner, it's two on with one out. And a strike on the inside corner to Soriano.
Joe, if I'm the Cubs, this is the one guy I do not want to see up here. He is one of the most dangerous, explosive hitters in baseball. The ball just fires off his bat.
Tied for first in the American League with his 18 home runs. Tied with Delgado. 0-2. Rankings in the American League this year for Soriano. Number one in hits in the major leagues. Tied for, or rather first in steals, tied for first in the home run department. Total bases. Ninth in RBIs. Tying runs are on.
Key here is not throwing a strike.
1-2, 97 miles per hour from Wood.
Soriano perhaps is as much as anybody in the game. You can toy with him once you go 0-2. Stay out of the strike zone and your chances are going to be better.
Clemens threw 84 pitches. Wood well up over 100. Two on, one out. And Soriano flies one to center. Coming in is Alou. Two out. Patterson, the center fielder, broke back after seeing that big swing. And Patterson thrilled to see Alou coming in to sweep in for the catch.
Center and right field here at Wrigley Field. Very difficult sun fields. It's number one now that Candlestick Park has been relegated to a football stadium. Candlestick used to be the toughest from right and center, but now it's Wrigley Field.
Now it's Derek Jeter, the second youngest Yankee captain ever, second only to Thurman Munson. He was named back in 1976. Tying runs are on, two out, strike one.
I'm a little bit surprised that Lenny Harris is still in the ball game for defense, and I'm also surprised to see him on the line. Derek Jeter does not, if there's anybody in baseball, you got to give him the line. Derek Jeter hits the ball to right center and right field. I think Lenny's too close to the line at third.
Too far inside, a ball and a strike. Giambi is on deck. And Mike Remlinger is getting loose, the left-hander for the Cubs in their bullpen. Jeter with two on, two out. Strike two. And with Kerry Wood due up first in the bottom of this eighth, this could be his final batter. And this crowd wants to see his 12th strikeout. Two and two. And by the way, a terrific block by Damian Miller to keep the tying run out of scoring position.
Yeah, the runner on second getting to third, not nearly as important as the runner on first getting to second.
Full count and the runners will go. This, you would have to believe, is Kerry Wood's last batter of the day, no matter what. Bases loaded, and now the decision. Dusty Baker just pointed down to the bullpen, but is still in the dugout for the moment. Kerry Wood is coming up.
Probably a double switch with Ramon Martinez going to third and batting ninth. And Remlinger in the game.
A 1-2 count on Jeter, and Wood lets him get away, and now Kerry Wood will have to go sit and watch his setup relief try to end the inning and keep the lead. Bases loaded, two out. Remlinger coming in. Martinez taking over at third. And the big left-handed slugger, Jason Giambi, coming up. The New York Yankees.
Stinking up my stuff.
These things are magic, Mikey.
Anybody could hit in these. Anybody, huh?
The new MLB Authentic Collection Performance Batting Practice jerseys and caps are here. Now anyone can get them.
Crackheads attack cops.
Freeze, or I'll put a hole in you.
And citizens fight back.
You guys have them tied up?
Yeah.
Outstanding.
Cops. Then witness a harrowing siege.
I did think I was going to die.
That led to incredible acts of courage. America's Most Wanted. It all starts at 8, 7 Central tonight on Fox.
Fox Sunday.
Beach parking, $20.
Forget you.
Start your summer with a bang.
I always wondered how those work.
And yet I've learned nothing.
We're celebrating fun in the sun with summer episodes of Futurama, King of the Hill, The Simpsons, Another King, Malcolm in the Middle, and Oliver Bean. So don't be a chicken.
He'll stop. I know he'll stop. Adventures wait just ahead.
Maybe this was just a...
Check out Fox Sunday Summer Celebration starting at 7, 6 Central.
Tired of all those shows with so-called real people that look anything but real? Well, don't hate them. Join them. This summer, we're sending 11 sexy singles to live in luxury at the exclusive Paradise Hotel. Now, for the first time ever, you can go from viewer to star just by watching. Because every week, someone new will join the cast, and that someone could be you. Paradise Hotel, premiering Wednesday, June 18th on Fox. Parental discretion advised.
Kerry Wood gets into the eighth inning, responsible for the three runners on the bases, goes 7 2/3, allows one run on three hits. The only run allowed so far, the home run by Matsui back in the fifth, which until the bottom of the seventh was good enough for a Yankee lead. Now it's the slugger for the Yankees, Jason Giambi, dealing with Mike Remlinger. Sacks jam, two out. Strike one. Remlinger is the type pitcher that the Yankees, after they let Stanton leave the ball club, really don't have, and that is a matchup lefty. Remlinger is that type for this situation with Giambi.
He's also very adept at getting right-handers and left-handers out.
On two.
Just showing him that pitch under the armpits, getting back away from the plate. I would think he'd go back outside with the fastball here. Back in.
Two and two. Standing down at second, go ahead run on at first for the Yankees, who have Giambi at the plate. He homered yesterday, he has 14 on the year. From 0-2 to 3-2,
he's got to throw him a fastball here. Predictable pitch. Giambi with good power the other way. He had a home run in yesterday's game.
Who cares what's in a hot dog? When diverse cast-aside elements come together to form something great, well, that's the American way. No, sir. Far better to ask yourself, what are you made of? What spice do you add to the national knockwurst? What flavor do you contribute to the high life?
Let's say this is you, and this is your auto insurance company. You've always gotten along okay, but let's say this is Allstate. Ooh, looks better than what you got now, huh? Well, qualified drivers who call Allstate for a free auto quote can get a company this good for this kind of price. Maybe less. The choice is pretty simple, don't you think? So call Allstate now for an auto quote and find out how you're in good hands with Allstate.
Gina, so where do you suppose he was going?
I think he's sitting at home and he says to himself, today's the day. Today I go for a little ride.
See, this just makes my day.
And that just made my day.
Introducing Picture Mail That Talks from Sprint. And now share all the pictures you want and get a PCS Vision Picture Phone for $99.99 after $100 savings. Share it when it happens.
This summer,
smart kid like you,
you gotta have a plan.
Journey to a whole new world.
You brought him home?
He's not a criminal mastermind. He's a kid who has nowhere to go.
What do you think of Newport?
I think I can get in less trouble where I'm from.
You have no idea.
The OC, coming soon to Fox.
Fox Saturday Baseball brought to you by Sprint. Introducing PCS Vision. Clearly a whole new way to look at wireless. By Old Spice. Spice things up. By Allstate. You're in good hands with Allstate. And by Miller High Life. To live simply, proudly, boldly, manly, this is the high life. Ramon Martinez, who took over in the double switch, will lead it off for the Cubs against Jeff Weaver, the third pitcher of the day, and now working out of the bullpen for the Yankees, losing his starter's spot after his last effort last weekend in Detroit. Martinez homered here yesterday. Very good, useful utility player is Ramon Martinez, who Dusty Baker had with the Giants. Changed up, and it's a one ball, two strike count. What a day at Wrigley. Two and two.
Joe, I saw that scorecard, and I remember Pat Piper, who was here for about 70 years. He was the public address announcer. Gave the lineups every day. He was also the ball man. Used to bring the balls up to the umpire, so he had a dual purpose. People familiar with Wrigley Field over the years can remember Pat Piper saying, "Ladies and gentlemen, get your pencils and scorecards ready."
Weaver. That one got away and almost got Martinez, and it's a full count. They see a load of ability in Jeff Weaver, but turning it into victories and consistent pitching has been tough.
Or your point earlier, what Joe Torre told us, that Contreras will be in the bullpen and a big asset to them once Weaver is straightened out.
And really, that's been one of the issues between George Steinbrenner and Joe Torre, Jose Contreras, and how it was handled when they sent him out. Joe Torre telling him initially that he was just going back to AAA, then word came from Tampa he was going down to Florida. Joe Torre was embarrassed. Felt like he had lied to the player as Jeter in the hole. That ball hits off Ventura's glove. Jeter goes to get it. And Martinez is on with what likely is a hit. And it is. Moments ago, Jason Giambi dealing with Mike Remlinger with the bases loaded. A 3-2 pitch in this. At first, nobody out here, and Grassalonic at the plate. Yankees expect the bunt just to finish on Contreras and Joe Torre. The perception is that George Steinbrenner said, "We're paying this guy $8 million a year for 4 years. He's got electric stuff. I want to see him in the rotation." Well, he eventually got into the rotation last Friday and was outstanding in a win over the Tigers. He won his last time out in Cincinnati as the bunt is good by Grassalonic. The sacrifice is good. 1-4. Down to second is Martinez. We give you our Pepsi All-Star ballot update. National League first. And right now it looks like this. Bonds, Guerrero, who just was put on the disabled list with a herniated disc in his back, and Sosa, Roland, Renteria, Kent, Bagwell on the infield, and Ivan Rodriguez behind the plate, right now leading in their categories with the votes. Ball one up and away to Alex Gonzalez.
Ivan Rodriguez has the luxury of catching one of the finest young arms I have seen in the major leagues in a long, long time. That's Dontrell Willis, the left-hander who's 4-1 for the Marlins. Boy, do I love to watch him pitch.
And you alerted me to the fact that he used to be in the Cubs organization.
Yeah, came over in the Al Fonseca deal.
By the way, is no longer the closer here with the Cubs. It's Joe Borowski who's getting loose, and he will take over. That's ball three, 3-0 with Corey Patterson on deck. Gonzalez, a sacrifice bunt, two ground outs.
Getting back to the Contreras, you saying that, look, we're paying him $8 million. We want to see him as a starter. you know, for George Steinbrenner and the partners of the Yankees to think by just having the highest payroll in baseball.
That's fair down the right field line, and it will add to the Chicago lead. In the score is Grisolanic on an RBI double by Alex Gonzalez.
And the Cubs tack on here in the eighth inning to take a three-run lead. RBI double off Jeff Weaver after the infield hit by Martinez. But to wrap up that point, just because you have the highest payroll in baseball doesn't mean it's a laydown, and that guys are going to just give you the pennant. You don't win the pennant at a bank or on Wall Street on a financial sheet. You win it between the lines, and the Yankees are not playing well right now.
And between the lines, Joe Torre is going to make another pitching change. Weaver is going to exit. It's a three-run Cub lead.
For the first time ever, the league that wins the All-Star Game will earn home field advantage in the World Series. The stakes are raised. The intensity is back. The 2003 All-Star Game, only on Fox. This time, it counts.
Fox Tuesday, the creators of American Idol continue their nationwide talent search for tomorrow's superstar. Now, as the 20 finalists are chosen, the contest is heating up.
'Cause I'm over you.
And the parents are melting down. American Juniors, hosted by Ryan Seacrest at 8 Fox Tuesday. This is Eddie.
Trust me.
This is England.
We do this weekend.
Hopefully you.
England, meet Eddie.
Wanker.
Brat.
I hate you too.
Wimp. New York's finest is on the case in London, and now his new roommate is on his.
This has been on a week. I feel like I know these apes.
Hasn't been that long since you broke away.
Scotland Yard is about to get yanked.
I'm Eddie. I like me so far.
Keen Eddie, all new at 9, 8 Central, Fox Tuesday. Fox tonight, crackheads attack cops.
Freeze, or I'll put a hole in you.
And citizens fight back.
You guys have them tied up?
Yeah.
Outstanding.
Cops. Then revisit a terrifying day in law enforcement history as a crazed gunman pins down police.
Call for backup.
And only a bold and dangerous plan could save them.
I did think I was going to die.
See the incredible acts of courage that ended a harrowing siege. An all-new America's Most Wanted. It all starts at 8 tonight on Fox. Fox Monday. For the first time on television, find out your IQ live. Discover if your intelligence is above average, gifted, or a genius. How does your IQ compare to this group of teachers, these construction workers, or this bevy of blondes? Do you have the guts to find out? Test the nation. What's your IQ? Monday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Chris Hammond takes over, and Corey Patterson swings over the top of a pitch. Strike one. Said earlier that the Yankees really don't have that matchup left-hander when Remlinger came in, because sometimes Hammond, because of his changeup, is tougher against right-handed batters.
That's right.
1-1. Juan Acevedo hanging his head in the dugout. He has not moved since being replaced in this game. Strike two on a huge swing by Patterson. 1-2 with Sosa on deck.
Now that was a head hanger that he gave up to Eric Karros. A high fastball, the first pitch of the ball game. Karros put the Cubs on top 3-1.
It's now 4-1. A hit by Martinez, a sacrifice bunt. I had said Grisolanic scored. It was Martinez who crossed the plate. The RBI double by Alex Gonzalez, and now a 1-2 pitch to Patterson. It's popped up. A changeup that worked against a lefty. Posada has it for the second out. Now Sosa will be the hitter. So you know, the Yankees bullpen has allowed 44% of inherited runners to score, which is the third highest number in the major leagues. Kansas City and Boston higher. Major league average is just over 34%, and the Yankees at 44%. So that's a spot, even with a $180 million payroll, that needs to be improved. With two outs, Sosa takes a ball up and away.
It's so alarming that what Yankee fans are comparing it to is the bullpen, as you mentioned earlier, the bullpen the Yankees have had in the past years. Jeff Nelson is now with Seattle. Mike Stanton now with the Mets, even though Stanton is ailing.
That's toward the middle. Jeter can't keep it on the infield. In to score is Gonzalez. Another run and an RBI for Sosa. And it's 5-1 Chicago in the eighth. Two hits and now an RBI today for Sosa.
That's a ball in past years that Derek Jeter would have dived for. But remember, he separated his shoulder early in the season, and that does not allow him to get the extension that Jeter is used to getting. That's a ball that he at least dives for and keeps on the infield to prevent the run from scoring. But not so coming back from that separated shoulder.
Lou with a swing and a miss. So Hammond adds to that percentage as he allows an inherited runner to score, and that's a two-run frame. A third of an inning for Weaver. One ball, one strike. Posada, Ventura, and Mondesi will bat for New York in the ninth inning. Should end the inning. Jeter with a flip, and that'll do it. It sends this game, a beautiful Saturday in Chicago, to the ninth. The matchup of Roger Clemens and Kerry Wood at the start. Battle of the bullpens late. The Cubs are on top, 5-1.
Michelin designed the cross-terrain SUV tires specifically for SUVs to help provide responsive handling and a smooth ride. You'd be surprised just how smooth. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
When you can get the best of wireless without a contract, that's M-Life. Go. Go phone. Only from AT&T Wireless. Let's go.
The guys are counting on me.
Gotta go.
Just one night.
Just one night.
Nice pants.
Nice pants.
Nice pants.
Hi.
Nice pants. What have they been?
The one and only Dockers Stain Defender. See?
Going to full 12 rounds is all about stamina. That's why I like High Endurance from Old Spice. No deodorant protects better. And it lasts longer because it evaporates more slowly. Want proof? If you're not convinced, Old Spice will buy you a stick of your old stuff. Let me put it this way. High Endurance will last longer than I do. But I'm working on that.
And start your day with new body wash and body spray from Old Spice. Spice things up.
On American Juniors, 20 finalists are chosen. And as the contest heats up,
this is a competition. There is a lot at stake.
The parents melt down. American Juniors at 8, 7 Central, Fox Tuesday.
Back at Wrigley, ninth inning, Joe Borowski, who was pitching in Mexico a couple of years ago, has elevated himself into the closer spot, taking over for Alfonseca. He was the guy Dusty Baker went to, and Alfonseca was injured at the beginning of the year. Look at these numbers. Why wouldn't you stay with him? 10 saves and a 1.67 ERA.
Prior to this year, he had two major league saves.
In for a strike, it's 0-2 on Posada. Borowski was going to give it up, go into line of work that members of his family, including his father, had gone into, and that was fighting fires. He's going to be a firefighter, came back, pitched in Mexico, worked his way back, was in the minor leagues with the Cubs, had a great year last year, and he's staying with it here in 2003.
Either way, he's putting out fires.
This one and this type just on the field trying to get the final three outs of a game, and he's done well for Dusty Baker. On 0-2. With Ventura next in a 5-1 game. That's ball one. MLB.com has the widest selection of items for the team you love. Shop MLB.com, the official site of wearing your heart on your sleeve, cap, pullover, and lots more. MLB.com. A 1-2 pitch. Posada waited on it, flips it out of play. Kerry Wood threw 120 pitches on the afternoon. That was good for 7 2/3 innings. He allowed one run, three hits, walked three. Left with the bases loaded, and Remlinger came on to strike out Giambi, leading by two on a 3-2 pitch. Another foul by Posada. The duel at Wrigley. And by the way, for Clemens, the word is his next scheduled start, as he again will be trying to win his 300th game. It'll be his fourth attempt at it. He'll also be trying to get to the 4,000 strikeout plateau. He came in needing nine, and he struck out five. Posada hits that one to deep left center field. That ball's got a chance. It's gone. Home run, Posada. And it's 5-2 Chicago in the ninth. As they do here at Wrigley, that souvenir is thrown back onto the field. And to finish the thought on Clemens, he is scheduled to pitch Friday. Right now, going into the game, Friday, at Yankee Stadium against St. Louis. You and I will be there next Saturday for the Cardinals and the Yankees. A little 1964 flavor for you. Staying with a backhand is the shortstop Gonzalez. One out. So next Saturday, Fox Saturday Baseball continues with exciting interleague play. Albert Pujols is hitting 390. He and the Cardinals take on the Yankees, or the Braves battle the Mariners. The Dodgers meet Cleveland. It all begins with This Week in Baseball at 11:30 Eastern, 8:30 Pacific, followed by NFL Europe's World Bowl, and then Fox Saturday Baseball at 3 Eastern, noon Pacific. So we'll start later because of the World Bowl, 3 Eastern next week. We'll be at Yankee Stadium for the Cardinals and the Yankees.
One added thing about Roger Clemens, keep in mind, and Joe, you said that earlier in the game, Roger has not won at Yankee Stadium this year. 6-0 on the road, 0-3 at Yankee Stadium.
An 84 pitch day, left in the seventh, and watched his one run lead leave seconds later on a home run hit by Karras against Juan Acevedo, as Mondesi, who is without a contract next season, gets a base hit. It's one on with one out, and Matsui is coming up.
Damian Miller, the catcher, out to talk to Joe Borowski. Dusty Baker does not have anybody warming up right now, but I would think somebody should get up, because Joe Borowski, I mean, after all, he is not the closer caliber of Mariano Rivera. Nor, in my opinion, has he pitched himself into that early in the first 2 months of the season.
Now with one on, one out, we're handed an interesting note. Matsui takes a ball high. The word is that Roger Clemens will not be addressing the media following this game because of an upper respiratory infection, which I'm sure will be cited as one of, if not the main reason why he was pulled out of this game in the seventh inning, which is something we talked about at the time. If he said, "This is all I've got, I'm ready to come out," then you make the move.
Carr was wheezing or something of that nature.
If not, who knows if it happened or not. If not, that move will be second guessed until he next pitches, most likely on Friday in the Bronx. Now the count's gone to 3-0 on Matsui. And if the Yankees can get one more base runner, they'll have a chance with a tying run at the plate, and it's hard to believe no one's getting loose.
It is hard to believe nobody is up in the Cubs bullpen.
3-1 on Hideki Matsui, who has homered and singled. The Yankees and the Yankee fans hope he figures it out at the plate. Came in hitting 259. To the right side and through for a base hit. And now the Yankees will bring the tying run to the plate. Alfonseca will start to get loose for Chicago. He was warming last inning, so it shouldn't take him long to get ready, as Larry Rothschild, the pitching coach, will come out and visit with Borowski, as there is still drama left in this game. Juan Rivera will be the hitter, and Todd Zeal has come into the on-deck circle with a pitcher's spot due up after Rivera. Home run, a ground out, back-to-back singles. The tying run will be at the plate in the person of Juan Rivera, who has not homered this season. 0 for 2 today and hitting below 200. He came in at 208. Getting his playing time because of the knee injury suffered by Bernie Williams. Move Matsui into center, and they put Rivera in left. First and third, one out. No swing. Ball one.
Now Rivera held up. Watch how he drags the bat head through. The hands came through, but the bat head stayed back. That's close. Closer than I thought, really.
One ball, no strikes. First and third, one out. One and one. Alfonseca started the season as the closer for Dusty Baker. As you look at what the Yankees have done this season when trailing after six innings compared to what they had accomplished 2001 and 2002. Rivera in the hole, one and two. Alfonseca started the season on the disabled list. A right hamstring pull. He's back healthy and warming up for the Cubs in their bullpen. As Borowski faces Rivera with one out. Two and two. Todd Zeal, a one-time Cub, waits to hit next. Now they will. No swing, says the first base umpire in his fourth year, Jim Reynolds.
Now you've got to throw a strike right here. You've got to challenge a guy struggling like Rivera instead of leaving it up to a more experienced, good clutch hitter like Todd Zeal, who's on deck. I don't send the runner right here. Line drive ends the game.
Not going. Struck him out. Two out. Now the tying run will be represented at the plate by Todd Zeal.
Eric Karros is going in front of first base, trying to find out by Dusty Baker what he wants him to do. In my view, you just play behind Matsui. You have a three-run lead with two runners on. Zeal is a guy who can rifle the ball down the right field side. So it looks to me like you ought to guard the line instead of holding Matsui on. Baker chooses not to do that.
First and third, two out. Zeal, who rarely swings at the first pitch, comes up empty.
Almost never.
Todd Zeal came up in the Cardinal organization, traded to the Cubs in 95, the same day St. Louis fired Joe Torre as their manager. Way late, strike two. Yesterday, the last time these two teams met in the World Series in 1938. The Chicago Cubs, if they can hang on and win, will beat the New York Yankees for the first time. Swept in 32, swept in 38. Cubs lost here yesterday to the Yankees 5-3. Lead 5-2 today. Two and two. No further word on Hee-Sop Choi, who left with the head injury. He was conscious. Taken to Illinois Masonic Hospital. And it was Karras who took over for him, who hit the go-ahead home run in the seventh. 2-2 to Zeal. Into right field. That ball, if it's fair, will drop for a hit. It is foul.
First hit, I thought that ball was fair from our angle, but it just drifted foul about 2 feet or so. Hit off the end of the bat. Todd Zeal will have to get a new piece of lumber, I think. Yeah, just foul. Two umpires down the right field line today.
Karras called it before Jim Reynolds. First and third, two out, tying run at the plate for New York. And a 2-2 count on Todd Zeal. Back to Borowski. The Cubs have defeated the Yankees. With the biggest swing of the bat today, and it was Kerry Wood winning his fifth as Roger Clemens lost his fourth and missed his chance for the third time to win the 300th game of his Hall of Fame career. No doubt, the great feat of the game brought to you by Dr. Scholes, the swing of the bat by Eric Karras on the first pitch from Juan Acevedo. To a ballpark, you have an anticipated matchup, you never know what you're going to see, and I think we saw about what we expected from Kerry Wood and Roger Clemens.
Yeah, I think so too, Joe, and a very important thing, not only did Roger Clemens lose the game, but he didn't win the game today, so the Yankees have to go through this another 5 days.
Let's go down to the field and check in with Kevin Kennedy.
Tough day today, obviously. Any update on, first of all, Hee-Sop Choi?
Well, from what I heard, they said that he was alert. He was talking. They just had to run some tests for precautionary reasons. But, you know, our thoughts are with Hee-Sop. I mean, if you saw that injury, that's something that obviously it looked horrific on the field. And, you know, hopefully he's going to rebound and be okay.
That's great news, Eric. And the irony of it all is you come up and really get the game-winning home run. Did you think you were going to face Roger Clemens in that situation?
You know, I wasn't sure. I know they'd gone out a couple of hitters earlier and talked to him. It looked like he was laboring a bit with Moises. I'm sure Joe Torre had a good reason. I don't know what the reason was, but I was prepared to hit off of Clemens or whoever they brought in.
How was Clemens' stuff today as far as what you saw up there?
Well, I mean, my first at-bat, well, my only at-bat off him, he threw me a couple fastballs to start off with and then the forkball. And forkball, when he's throwing that thing and throwing it over, I mean, that's an unhittable pitch. And, I'm saying they should outlaw that darn thing because it's not fun. But he had good stuff today.
How did you guys feel with the matchup of Kerry Wood, a young Texan going for his 50th win versus Roger Clemens coming into this series?
Well, I mean, it had all the hype. Kerry's got great stuff. He's got electric stuff. And, he had thrown a one or two hitter up until he was taken out. And, he's a guy that can dominate any day. And we knew we were going up against a guy that could dominate as well. And there weren't going to be a lot of hits. And, whatever team made the fewest mistakes was going to come out on top.
Thanks so much, Eric. Congratulations. All right, Joe, let's go upstairs.
Thanks to Eric Karras. Thank you, Kevin, for joining us today. For Tim McCarver, I'm Joe Buck, the coordinating producer of baseball on Fox and the producer of today's game, Michael Weissman. Our director, John Moore, the associate director, Larry Lancaster, and the broadcast associate, Eric Billigmeier. Some of many who brought you this game from Wrigley Field, a beautiful afternoon in Chicago. On the north side, the Cubs have now defeated the New York Yankees. That swing by Karras, a big part of it. Wood over his boyhood hero, Roger Clemens, today. What more do you want? Let's go out to L.A. and Jeannie Zelasco.
What more do we want? We're looking for cash, guys. Thank you. Today, of course, home runs making a difference. Fox Sports, in partnership with CapCure, will make sure that every home run hit in today's games will help fight prostate cancer. Three at Wrigley, a total of seven. That's $135,000 and counting. Hi, everyone, and welcome inside the Fox Network Center. I'm Jeannie Zelasco, and we wanted to share with you the keys to this one. The big move of the game, of course, will be Roger Clemens getting pulled after six and a third in his replacement, Juan Acevedo. First pitch to Eric Karras. Pretty deep. It's a three-run home run, and this one not meant to be. Roger Clemens, obviously, a little frustrated. 84 pitches and thinking that he should still be pitching in the game and looking for a chance to get that 300th win. It is elusive at this point as he has dropped four, and the Cubbies get the victory. And we're just going to update the CapCure numbers for you one more time. It's $105,000. So we have seven home runs. We're still looking for the home runs, so that number will still go up. Roger Clemens, of course, telling us that he has all the patience in the world, and that's going to happen when it happens. So the next shot, of course, would be Friday at Yankee Stadium when the St. Louis Cardinals come to town. And right now, it looks like it could be Matt Morris. He does pitch on a Sunday for the Cardinals. The Cards have an off day on Monday, so the Cardinals are telling us that there could be a chance for a Morris-Clemens showdown. We know this is happening tomorrow. NASCAR Winston Cup Racing returns to Fox. Live from Pocono, Dale Jarrett looks to defend his title against the best drivers in the world in the Pocono 500 presented by Subway. Coverage begins tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern and 9:30 Pacific, only on Fox. And next week, Fox Saturday Baseball returns with more exciting interleague play. Kevin Kennedy, my pal, will be back in studio. The Cardinals look to keep pace in the tight NL Central when they face the Yankees, or the Braves battle the Mariners. Maybe the Dodgers squaring off against the Indians. A full day of action on Fox Sports begins next Saturday, 11:30 a.m. Eastern, 8:30 Pacific, with This Week in Baseball, followed by NFL Europe's World Bowl, and then Fox Saturday Baseball, special time this coming weekend, 3 Eastern, noon Pacific. Well, we were all waiting for history, but it was not meant to be. Roger Clemens will look again for win number 300. Kerry Wood, by the way, getting career win number 50 as he tries to best his idol. Many years of more baseball to come. Thanks for joining us. See you next Saturday.
Has been a presentation of Fox Sports.
I'm sold. It's got to be the Explorer.
I agree. The smooth car-like ride and the great handling make me feel safer.
And look what I found. Explorer is the best pick by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety.
No wonder it's the best-selling SUV in America.
And the most trusted.
You know, the others just didn't come close to Explorer's handling.
The only decision left is the 0 for 60, or Ford matches our down payment up to $1,000 for a total of $4,500 down.
Let's go pick it up and we can talk about it on the way.
If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again. This family did.
Need help with your yard this weekend? We're free.
buy almost any John Deere lawn or garden tractor right now, and it's free till April 2004. Zero down, 0% interest, zero payments till next season. So visit your John Deere dealer now and start thinking up projects, because we're free till April.
We see an architect, a 23-city tour, the next big idea. We stand in awe of you and your creative potential. It's what inspires us to create software that helps you reach it.
Well, aren't we feeling grown up today?
The all-new 2003 Lincoln Navigator. There are those who travel and those who travel well.
Reloaded is amazing. Two thumbs way up. Find yourself a movie house with seatbelts. It's an incredible ride. The Matrix Reloaded. Rated R. Everywhere.
Corey McFerrin here on The Final Word tomorrow night. Olympia Fields braces for the Open, and just like old times, the Cubs and Yanks back together again Sunday night at 10.
Baseball in Chicago, where two of baseball's most beloved franchises renew their relationship in a day when Roger Clemens' bid for history is denied again. Hello again, everybody. Corey McFerrin live at Wrigley Field, and so many storylines to talk about today. First, obviously, the historic aspects of the Cubs and Yankees getting together here at Wrigley Field for the first time in 65 years. Then there's Roger Clemens, foiled in his bid to make history today and win his 300th ball game, foiled by a young man by the name of Kerry Wood, who grew up in Texas, one of his biggest fans ever. And then there's the sight, the terrible sight of Hee-Sop Choi lying motionless here on the third baseline. We'll update you on that. All of this with the specter of Sammy Sosa and the cork bat controversy hanging in the air. We'll get to all of those issues in the next half hour. Again, the Cubs win the ball game by a final of 5-2, and I believe we have someone at the podium. Dusty Baker is speaking to the media right now.
This one in particular, do you think this is going to get him going again?
Well, he had a one-hitter, no-hitter going into the fourth or fifth, his last start. And I said before the game that if he could, you know, take that same pitching performance into this game, that he had a great chance to win. And, he was sharp from the opening pitch. And, Woody could have a lot more wins. He doesn't. We talked about the other day, whoever pitches against Woody is going to pitch his best ball game. I mean, that's what happens, when you're facing the ace of the staff. And, he alluded to the fact that he remembers when Randy Johnson a few years ago wasn't getting any runs. But it's not his team's fault as much as it is the credit of the opposing pitcher.
I know a regular season game with all the hype about Roger Clemens going on. Can this propel you into some future games? I mean, can this be a springboard for the team?
Well, we hope so. I mean, we're trying to get to 10 over 500. And, we played good defense. We executed properly, all except a time or two. And, You know, we were not worried about springboard, and we got another tough dude tomorrow in Andy Pettit. So we just got to come out tomorrow. We got a very, very, very formidable pitcher going in Mark Pryor tomorrow. And our whole thing is to win the series. So now we're tied at 1-1, and I guess first time the Cubs beat the Yankees in, what, 70 years or whatever it is, You know.
Since Double Day.
Considering that. Since Double Day, huh? I wasn't around Double Day.
Considering the whole situation, my man is the Yankees, everything was gone. How impressed are you Woods' performance that he was able to
step Well, I was impressed with both of them. I mean, Roger was dealing too. You know, both of them are dealing. Just you knew something was going to break sooner or later. I'm just glad that we got those base runners on for Eric to, you know, hit that home run. So I was very impressed with Carey. I'm always impressed with Carey. Just today, Carey was a victor.
Was there any difference in his demeanor at all in this game? Did he look any more pumped up?
No. It's hard to tell when Carey's pumped up. You know, Carey's Carey. I'm sure inside, you know, I mean, he wanted to win this game, you know, very badly. There was a change in his demeanor after Big Choi got hurt. You know, I could see him in the dugout in between innings, just sort of, you know, sitting there, you know, contemplating, you know, what had happened. But he turned it on when he needed to.
After the hitter after the injury, he struck out Posada. What do you think that kind of meant to him, or what did it
I don't know. You have to ask him that. I mean, you know, the game must go on. It goes on without any of us. I mean, to me, I'm impressed with the young man, how he turned his competitive juices back on.
All right, we're going to let Dusty go.
Thank you.
We're going to have Mike Rullinger, Kerry Wood, Eric Harris, and we're also going to...
And what a job by Kerry Wood. Finally wins a game, his first since April 29th. Didn't give up a hit until the Hideki Matsui home run in the fifth inning. His line scored the day, 7 2/3 innings pitch, gives up 3 hits, 1 run, 1 earned run, 2 walks, and 11 strikeouts as Kerry Wood outduels Roger Clemens. Right now, back to the podium. Let's see who we've got. Looks like Mike Remlinger, who came on to strike out Jason Giambi in dramatic fashion after relieving Kerry Wood.
Well, I mean, as relievers, that's really what we live for, is come in a high-pressure situation with the game on the line and ideally some of the game's best hitters at the plate and just see what you have. And got ahead of him early, which is what you're ideally trying to do in that situation, and then tried to make a couple pitches. He laid off some pretty good pitches and was finally able to make a good 3-2 changeup pitch.
Was it difficult to refocus as a team after Aesop went down?
Maybe for the first few minutes. The end that I was really impressed with Carey to be able to go out there and finish that inning the way he did. It was something that obviously, I mean, we see a lot of different things happen in this game, and we understand that there's a certain amount of risk involved with what we do, and the problem with that is that you don't usually see it firsthand. You usually see highlights about it or something like that. So it was definitely something that put a little bit of a scare into all of us, and our understanding is that he's going to be okay and hopefully be able to go see him later on tonight. I don't know if that's going to be possible, but I think we really showed a little bit of makeup on this team to be able to pull together and come back from that, because very easily could have just said, you know, game's secondary now. And again, that's part of what we do, is we're used to dealing with distractions or major problems. And you know, I just think it's a credit to the guys on this team.
You came out onto the field to talk with Reed. What did you try to impart? Settle him down or say?
I just tried to tell him to make sure that he, you know, as good as he was going, he needed to make sure that if he needed a reason or something to focus on to keep himself going was to make sure he finished his job for Aesop, because he would want nothing else than that. You know, because things like that happen. I've seen some bad collisions in my day, and it was just, it's very easy to get upset and to not be as concerned about what's going on in a baseball game when you're talking about someone's livelihood and their well-being. And so I just really tried to get Carey to as much time as he needed to really take his time and if nothing else, just reach out there and focus on it, just to keep Aesop's, you know, keep him happy and give him something to focus on.
Mike Remlinger live in the podium area here underneath the...